Hey everyone, this is Chris. Welcome back to Day 12 of Inktober. Today we're drawing Orochimaru, a villain from the hit manga and anime Naruto. Now today's prompt is slippery, so I went with the slippery snake Orochimaru, who is also one of the legendary three ninja in this universe. Now this antagonist fits the bill for that sort of creepy villain that does a lot of weird things. And ever since I was a kid, I've always liked villains a lot more than heroes. There's something about villains that always look way cooler. I guess it's subjective what's cool, but the aesthetics and the costumes and powers that villains are given are always meant to be something that the protagonist or the hero has to overcome. So it's usually something very powerful and strong, or they're really good at what they do. I guess that makes him really appealing. Now, I wouldn't say Orochimaru is the coolest looking villain, but his abilities in the show really are something that others can't replicate or can't really achieve. He's really unique and uses snakes as his trademark moveset. He can summon snakes, he has snake-based attacks, and he even acts like a snake at times with his tongue sticking out or his slithery movements. His eyes, everything about him screams snake. Now back on that topic about villains always looking cooler than heroes, that's for the most part. Maybe it's because we've gotten so used to looking at heroes, and a lot of times they wear a lot of bright colors or something that's very neutrally heroic. Something that stands out. And there are obviously exceptions to that, but for the most part, heroes always don't tend to wear the huge spiky shoulders, or have the sharp teeth with the evil grins. And again, that's for the most part. I think part of that has to do with this rebellious nature that a lot of people tend to gravitate towards. Or something abnormal and opposite to you is always interesting or intriguing. And that's probably the main reason why I like villains so much. Right now, one of my favorite villains that kind of fits this role perfectly is Garo from One Punch Man. You know, he says that he rejects both sides, the monsters and the heroes. And as a kid, whenever Garo would watch these TV shows about superheroes versus monsters, he'd always wonder, when is the monster gonna win? Oh, the monsters are trying so hard. These villains are trying so hard to beat the heroes, and the heroes always team up against the monsters. This poor monster is just trying his best to beat them, but he always gets ganged up on. And then from there, he starts seeing that a lot of people are underrated or underappreciated and overshadowed by these heroes. Where from the monsters' perspectives, they might just be trying to live their own lives. But they get destroyed just because they're monsters. Although that's not to say, a lot of them, if not most of them, do some heinous things, so it probably is deserving. But it's nice to have that other perspective. And I think perspective is the major key for a lot of these things. And that's what makes a good villain. You know, you can have the coolest, strongest villain, but if they don't have a nice motivation behind them, then I'm not really going to care for them. I may like them on the surface level, but it won't go beyond that. I won't be thinking of them a lot unless they do something that really stands out, or unless I can sympathize with them or connect with them, relate to them in some way. That's why when there are final showdowns between the hero and the villain, if it's done right with us knowing the motivation behind the villain, a lot of times I can add a huge impact to that final battle where you're almost rooting for both sides. Because you can understand both sides. You've seen both perspectives now. Okay, so this video is going to have a shorter discussion. I'll leave you all with the rest of the drawing, and I'll see you on day 13. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Check out the rest of the Inktober playlist for 2020. And I'll see you all on the next video. Have a great rest of your day.